to do mock exam and explain the midterm exam. And I'm going to let you guys leave for to do the exam and so on. And you can like send message to ask me any question you may have other than the one the things that I talk about. Okay, let me share. Where the hell is my, oh, here. Let me share my screen. Okay, here you are. This is the midterm, and I mean the mock exam. First question is asking about what is the Galerian algorithm. So I cannot ask this question in the exam anymore, but okay. Tone of the exam going to be like this. When you finish your school, your university, get a degree, and you try to get a job, chance if you get a job from a decent company, chance are they going to ask this question? And chance are they going to ask you if you want to be a dev? People going to ask you to demonstrate some skill to show that you understand algorithm. Actually, data structure algorithm is like one of the most basic question that they're going to ask if you want to be a dev. So prepare for this. And first one, ask what is the greedy algorithm. You should be able to tell them clearly what is the greedy algorithm. It means that when you have a problem and you try to formulate a path from the starting point to the goal, there are so many paths from the starting point to the goal. If you fix to the best path possible and keep going on the best path possible until you reach a goal, this is the greedy algorithm. The good thing about greedy algorithm is that it's very fast. It took only one path, and if you can prove that your path is like the same number of n, your path is like sometimes your path is like even log n, right? So is the path that you take that is greedy, right? Now the hard part of the greedy algorithm, when you talk to the interviewer or try to explain to someone, the hard part of the algorithm is that you have to prove that even though you look at only one path, the best path, until you reach the end, this is actually the correct path, the optimal path, that there is like no better path, right? And we do this using we done task scheduling, right? We done task scheduling, we done coefficient, we just like talk about it. We done task scheduling, and we have to prove it that picking the task that finished first is like the best way to do it, right? So the key point of the greedy algorithm is to prove that it actually works, that it actually is the optimal solution. Now, sometimes greedy is not, this is an extension. Sometimes greedy is not like the best, so doesn't give you the best solution, but you can guarantee that it like it fit in like 15% of the best solution. You can use that answer, right? Something like that, but that's like more advanced algorithm that we can talk about. Okay. Next, the Kai-Bressa algorithm in terms of greedy algorithm, what is the greediness of the algorithm? Greediness of the Dijkstra algorithm is that it's like the best path to took is the best path that starts from A, starting from sort to any node that is like the shortest possible. that it actually is the greediness, right? You are not going to look at another way rather than the one that the node that is like the smaller distance from the starting point. Okay. Now, the third one, each binary search is a greedy algorithm. This one is, well, you can say yes and no, right? It's not a greedy in the sense that it took only one path. But actually, well, it actually took only one path, right? And what is the best way? What is the best, what is the greediness of the binary search? The greediness of the binary search is that you took the path that remove search space, remove like most search space remove search space as much as possible, right? Okay, I think I should write something. Okay, the first one is easy, so I am too lazy to write something down. You can try to listen to it and write it down yourself, or you can go back and listen to the recording of this. Okay, now, let's see, I have a camera set up somehow. But what is it pointing at? Okay. There you go. It's a little lopsided. Okay. And I'm going to put it down a little so. There you go. Now, the next one is dynamic programming. Dynamic programming, what is the short bot? Is RTBOT. Actually, I already forgot. Okay, it is a problem, right? R is relation. Actually, R is like recurrent relation, recursive relation or something like that. Recursive relation or something like that. T is first T. There are two T, right? One is topological structure. The last one is time. B is best case. And say O is original problem. Okay. So, is ThoughtBot is a framework to try to formulate a dynamic programming. A framework. Actually, you should use your own word. So. You have to change this falafel this somehow. A framework for developing dynamic programming solution to a problem. Okay. So. With that in mind, we say that we use Fibonacci as an example, right? I ask you guys to give an example using Fibonacci. What is the sub problem? Let's say if we want to find F, you can start with F5 or Fn or anything, but try to give a specific example. It's going to be easier to draw a graph. Okay, what is relation? Okay, we have Fn plus 1 equal to Fn plus Fn minus 1. Actually, I shouldn't write it as a function, but anyway. So this is the subproblem, right? Fn greater than or less than or equal to 5, right? And then this is sub question, this is relation, this is topological. Now, Supercharge we can start from 0 or we can start from 5 let's start from 5 5 f5 f4 f3 f3 f2 f2 f1 f2 f1 f1 f0 right f1 f0 and then f1 f0 and you can draw this graph this one sorry this one and this one okay and topological order the topological order of this is this way from 0 to 3 to 2 to 1 and actually everything go back to 5 sorry everything point up to 5 this is a topological order you can do any of this first right and then you can do any of this and then you can do any of this like in the topological order right and this work because we memorize right we memorize let's say f3 we memorize f3 we're not going to recompute anything so when you do this thing and when you do this to the bottom two right and then you try to do this one you anything that you already compute you just use the thing that you already the recorded value and you just compute this one and in this one you just use the record value and compute only one right so each step except the first one you only compute one right at a time so big O become N okay and this is the time this is the time ON sorry the time complexity and what is the best case best case is 2 right f0 and s1 f1 f0 and original problem is f5 okay you don't have to start from like 10 or something some really big example you can start from like very very small example when you explain this now in the actual exam I give you specific problem to work on now I don't know if that problem is too big or not if it's too big you have to reduce the graph somehow you may like draw only the relevant problem relevant part of the graph something like this try to explain as if I don't know this actually try to explain as if you try to prove to me that you understand that is like the main purpose of the exam anyway try to explain as if you try to prove to me that you understand the concept you understand the problem you can use the problem that's why I need the video right I want to hear you say how you say it how you understand it how you can explain it to me paper is like well two thing one thing paper is like hard to communicate right the other thing is like it's take home I don't know the paper you can like just copy the result somewhere okay that's like 2.2 the arc number well okay this one I'm going to skip because it's actually not in the like midterm exam right and midterm exam I forgot what problem I give you guys I will it's the lotto I will explain that problem okay I just skip this one okay shorted part this one is like no-brainer you can try to find example actually I took this graph from some page. So you should be able to search, reverse search and try to find this graph. Actually, you can search like Bellman-Ford algorithm example or something like that. You will see these two graphs because it's a mock exam. And you can see the answer to this. Again, you have to try to explain it as if you want to prove that to me that you understand this, right? I don't want to know the answer. I want to know that you understand this. Keep in mind when you said. And the A star algorithm is the big one, right? Okay, I will explain in the actual exam because I use this, at least part of this as a actual exam. Okay, let's look at the actual exam. Midterm exam. Okay, you have to record. I read the instruction later. Let's try to understand everything first. Okay, give the algorithm. Try to explain Huffman coding. You guys remember Huffman coding, right? What is the gradient of the algorithm? How can you prove that it correct? I don't know if you guys can prove this. I don't know if you have enough tools to prove it, but try to prove it that it's correct. Okay, and use this graph. So actually 1.1 and 1.2, actually it's only one problem in mock exam, but I try to separate it to two parts. So you have a space to draw this topology graph. Okay. And last one, we talk about binary search last time, right? About sequential search. Can you explain it? At least it's a greedy algorithm. Yes or no? You can justify your answer. Now, use expand sortbot. Use this. This is the longest increasing subsequent. So in this one, going to be like 10 and 14, I think, or 2, 6 and 14, with there are a lot of answer, right? 8, 10 and 14, right? But only 3. We have only 3 sequence, not 4, right? So the longest subsequent is only 3, but I'm not asking you to tell me that there are like 4 of them, 3 of them or something like that. I'm asking you to try to show me that longest increasing subsequent problem can be done using dynamic programming which fit into this sortbot framework, and you can draw this topological order or topological graph, right? You can draw this graph for me. Something like that. Again, everyone know how to, everyone should know how to implement or understand the algorithm for searching for this longest increasing subsequent. We do it in the class. Now, can you explain it clearly and using this example? Okay, next one. Okay, this one going to be the hard one. We even have 2.2.1 and 0.2. This one is lotto number. Actually, you can view it as if you like a man from the future that go back to the past and buy a lotto, or you can view yourself as someone who can fix the lotto number. Now, the thing is, we don't care about the lotto number because we can fix, right? But the situation is that the lotto is come out every day. You can buy lotto every day, and you can win every day if you want, because you can fix the number. You have a system. You have a power to fix the number, so you have a power to win every day, but you should not why because people are going to be suspect suspicious right people are going to come after you if you win every day so you try to maximize your profit by but you going to make yourself less suspicious by win only at most twice in 7 days so if you have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 right if you have this 7 slot you can win any of this right you can win this one or this one or you can win this one and this one we don't care right the problem don't care so if you have like 8 slot now you can win this one and any of this one right so this one so when you look at only 7 consecutive days you win only 2 right now if let's see if the price are the same every day you can just like try to maximize by going as much as you can in within 5 day or in 10 day period right so if you have like let's if you have 7 day you have to you can win 2 if you have more than 7 day but less than 14 day you can win 3 right if you have 14 day exactly 14 day you can win 4 right something like that now the two complicated things you can win different amount each day So if you buy a lotto on the first day, you get 6. Well, you can say a million, 6 million. If you buy it in like the second day, you get 1 million. If you get it in third day, you get 5 million, something like that. Now, you try to maximize your profit. But you don't want to win more than 2 days within any 7 days. So we have 6, 1, 5, 9, 8, 3, 4, 7, 2. This is the example. So let's say this 7 day, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this 7 day. Within this time frame, you can, this is 6, sorry. This 7 day. Within this time frame, you can win only 2 at most. So if you look at this time frame, you're going to pick this 2, right? But if you pick this 2, right, within this 7 time frame, let's say, if you pick this 2, within this 7 time frame, you can get only this 2, right? You cannot get any more. And within this time frame, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, within this time frame, you can only get this 2. So your profit right now is... Your price right now is 17 million. Okay. Let's make it a million so it's like add some dramatic effect. Now, if you carefully, if you pick this one and this one, and let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, you can pick this one too. Right? Because if you pick this 7, you win only 2, right? And you pick this 7, you can pick this 2, right? And you can pick this 7, well, this is the better choice. So, if you pick like this, your price become 22 million, right? Yeah, 22 million, same as I say. So, I think this is like the maximum profit. I don't know because I haven't programmed to search for the actual the actual maximum profit. Now, this is your task. You have to do this. You have to write a program to solve this. Now, since it's a take-home exam, the good thing about take-home exam is that I can ask you guys to write a program. This is fun for me, I think. Okay. First, describe your algorithm using SOLVEbot. And give the example by drawing the topo use the given example use this example for drawing the topological graph right and the second one implement your algorithm using Java so I don't have space for this one because you have to hand in the Java you don't have to write anything here or maybe you can write the file name I don't know okay so this is I think this is hard enoughThis is hard enough, so please take time to do this. I mean, to try to think of this one. And lastly, oh, not yet. Sorry. The third part. This one do the Bellman-Ford, and this one do the Foy-Voyshaw. Okay, these two graphs I just made it up. So do not try to search for the answer from the internet.It's not going to be there. And the last one. Okay, this one is new. I asked you to apply this A-star search algorithm. So you have to show me step by step on how to reach this C from this A. And this the orange this or this orange number next to the node is the heuristic.So from A to C, we estimate that it's going to take 7 steps or 7 units. I don't know. From E to C, we estimate that it's going to take 2, but it actually take 5. I don't know why. Anyway, that's it, right? So you have to follow this, this graph and explain the how A star doing something like that.And this one, right? I asked you to implement add puzzle in the mock exam. If you already have that, it's going to save you sometimes. If not, well, you have to write it anyway. The only thing different between things that I asked you in mock exam and this one is that in this one, you have to run a comparison test between two, right? We have to h. First one is the Manhattan distance from of the blank space to its correct position. So only the blank space. I only care the blank space. So if you have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right?And it's over. Let me see. Okay. This is good. Okay. Let's say, and this is the blank space, right? And the correct blank space is here, right? The correct place of the blank space is here. So Manhattan distance is 1, 2, 3. So H1 equal to 3, right? But H2.Is the number of incorrect tie including the space? So H2 of x, this actually x, right? H2 is okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 is correct one, right? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 only correct. So this is on equal to 8 number of correct.Number of incorrect, right? Because as you get closer, the distance between the current board position and the solution should be smaller, right? Let's see. If you have this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, blank space and 8.This is H2 equal to 2. H1 of this X equal to 1. Right? Okay. These two are not optimal solution, right? The optimal solution is, well, at least what people use is the Manhattan distance of every piece add together. That is like very optimal solution that people use. I don't know if they like maybe the better solution out there. But anyway, so this is two non-optimal solution. But nevertheless, I'm going to ask you guys to compare these two. So you have to implement this add puzzle, right? You have to implement two heuristic given a board, right? So board you can use an array. And this one, going to be 5, 0. You can use 0 as bank, right? 0, 7, 4, 3, 1, 8, 2, and 6, right? I think. Okay. So this is top three, right? This top middle, the middle three, and then this is the bottom three, and this is the space. Okay. You have to write two function h1 and h2, and you given this one of them going to the h1 going to give 5. Given this one, the h2 going to give 8. H2 going to be very easy, right? But anyway. Actually, if you to change this blank space to 10, it's going to be very, very easy, right? But anyway, that is. And you have to randomly create this, right? Something like this, 5, 1, 4, 2, 8, 0, 6. Is it all? 1, 2, 4, 5, 9. Something like that. Randomly create this and put it in your program and run and compute the time. Now, I don't know if it's going to be too fast to record time or not because I haven't tried this. If it, okay, I have to put down some notes. If it's too fast to record the time, you you can change to 15 puzzle. There are two solution. One is you can change to 15 puzzle. That's not going to be that hard. If you do this generic enough, it's not going to be that hard. You can change to 15 puzzle, or you can rather than run one time, run this one time, you can run it like a million times, not 100 times, something like that. And run it enough time to make the time recordable. Right? So to make the time recordable. The recordable time going to be somewhere around like more than 10 seconds up to 10 minutes if you're willing to wait. But if it me, I'm going to wait at more like a couple minutes. I'm too lazy to wait. But anyway, this one, this exercise, this not exercise, this question is designed to have you guys prove to me which one is better. You have to be able to prove to me benchmarkingly. I don't know how to. they use the word empirically, sorry. Want you guys to prove to me empirically, it means that you do the experiment and record the time. So you should be able to decide the experiment by yourself. You have like almost everything. The thing that you don't have is like the proper number of run to record the time or you can change to 15 puzzle, something like that. I think 15 puzzle might also be too fast in today's standard. I implemented this long time ago, and I don't know how much time changed. I used to do like magic square 3 by 3 which if you boot for it it 9 factorial is like 2 or 300,000 I think two or 300,000 bow mutation which is like very 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 large from standard of computer in my time right I start it from I start it in the evening and it's done like the next day but right now if you brute force it it run in like couple second it computer today is like that fast compared to computer at my age but anyway so you should be able to run a benchmark on this to program benchmark of your own program but anyway so that's it for the exam and let's go back and look at the instruction I'm asked you have to do all the problem I asked you to record 1.2 which is the explanation of the Huffman algorithm using this example right and 2.1 what is 2.1 2.1 and using shortboard explain the long gate increasing subsequent you know how to do well at least most of you should know how to do this should know how to do this right but can you explain it and lastly is t.2 follow this graph and using follow this algorithm Foy-Warshaw algorithm when applied to this graph okay if you do not do the first one 1.2 you can substitute it using like 1.3 so if you do not do this one do this one try to explain the sequential search if you do not do the second one 2.1 you can do 2.2.1 is this one right the lotto but the only the shortboard because it, this one is like programming Java and if you do not do this one the second one right if you do not do this one you can substitute it with this one t.1 or this one so it's the same kind of question typically you if you do not do any explanation of this if you do not finish any of this question you can like substitute it with the question of the same type something like that okay now hello any question
what if we did one of them like write it on paper but we don't want to explain does this mean we can choose to 3.1 or 4.1 etc
No. If you do 1.2, you must do 1.2. You cannot substitute with 1.3.
So even if we write it down, we have to explain.
Yes.
Okay.
You have to actually. You have to do both. You have to write it down and you have to explain. You have to write it down in the in this exam, and you also have to explain the your answer. Let. Okay. Okay.
Right, one question, please.
Yes.
Do we have to print out this exam or can we just write the questions and answer on a separate piece of paper? And then scan it and send to you.
If you write it using actual pen, I want you to use the exam paper. If you want, I want you to print it out and write it on exam paper because it's easier for me because it's going to be organized, right? Because if you write on a blank sheet of paper, some of you going to be like 1.1 and then 2.2 and then go back to 1.2, something like that. And it's hard for me to find which answer it which. Right?
Okay. Understandable.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
And if you after you record a video, please do not put it on Microsoft Teams because the interface is really suck. Sorry. So put it on your Google Drive, your OneDrive or anything, and share the link for me, or put it on YouTube and give me the link. It's going to be easier for me to watch it. Right, I try last time. It's not very good in Microsoft team, but anyway. And you have to turn in this exam paper, right? You can write it. You can print it out and write it with actual pen and pencil or something, pen or pencil or something. Or you can use electronic pen and write it on a PDF. As long as it is like your handwriting, I'm okay with it. I actually don't want you to type it. It's hard for me to prove that it's like actually your work. Sorry about that. And anything else? That's it. That is all the points on exam that I'm going to talk to you. Okay, I'm not going to teach you anything new today because I don't think you have a will to learn today. Anyway, so please start on your exam as early as possible. This is the hard exam. This is like really hard exam. Even though they only four problem, it actually is a hard exam, right? So, good luck.
Okay.
Any question before I dismiss the class?
Wait. So sure. If you run it, hello?
Sure.
Hello?
Yes.
If we do run out of paper on the, so I'm going to write it with like pen and paper. If we do run out of space, we can attach it to the end, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, all right.
Just Pete indicated clearly that there are more answer on another piece of paper, something like that. See the last page, something like that. Okay. Do not just write it down.
All right, okay.
Anything else? Okay. Let me remind you one thing. We didn't have any homework in the first half of our semester, right? So this exam actually going to take 50% of your grade, or maybe less. If I'm going to give you some project or some homework to do in the second half of this class, but on the first half I don't give any homework or assignment. So we don't have any point from that, any score or any mark from that. So you have to try to finish this as best as possible because it counts a lot, at least like 40 or 50% of your grade. A lot of pressure. Anything else? Okay then, good luck with the exam. Bye. Bye.
Thank you.
So can we write